Dear students, today we are going to discuss the details about tour operation process and what are the stages of itinerary development and tour package management. And in the last, we'll also try to learn sample domestic and international itinerary, as well as how to do this basic costing. So let us start with understanding what is a travel agency and what is tour operation business. So as you know, that travel agent is a person who has a full knowledge about tourism products, whether it is a destination, transportation, accommodation, ancillary services. You must be knowing about the concept of 5A. So on the behalf of the primary service provider, travel agency act as an intermediary between primary service provider and customer. So it may assemble all the product and services provided by primary service provider and offer to the client. So what is then a tour operator? So generally, a tour operation business is run by a firm or company who buys individual travel components separately from their supplier in a bulk or in a retail and combined into a tour package, which is sold with their own prices to public directly or through the middleman, that is a franchisee of a tour operator company, or maybe it should be sold to a travel agency. So these are, if you try to understand what are the types of travel and trade intermediaries, those who are part of tourism industry. So when we see those travel intermediaries, then majorly it is divided into two. One is travel agency and other is tour operation. So when we see travel agency, then it is having two part, retail travel agency and wholesale travel agency, while tour operation generally divided into four parts: inbound tour operators, IBT, outbound tour operators, OBT, ground operators, and domestic tour operators. Let us learn a bit in detail that what are the types of travel agency and tour operators. So retail travel agency, by the name itself, it's clear that they purchase from the different suppliers and sell in a retail to the client. Wholesale travel agency, generally they purchase in a bulk and they may sell directly or they provide to smaller travel agency, that is retail travel agency. When we see types of tour operators, as we have already seen that inbound tour operators, you know very well what is inbound tourism. So those tourists who are coming inside your own country from outside, they are called inbound tourists, and those services given to inbound tourists are by inbound tour operators. So they receive guest and client and handle arrangement in the host country. They are called inbound tour operators. Outbound tour operators are the company who promotes tour to a foreign destination for leisure, business or MICE are called outbound tour operators. So if an Indian company selling tour packages outside of India, let us say example of Europe, then they are called outbound tour operators. Domestic tour operators, the operators which are serving within a country and selling their tour packages, designing the tours for host population, that is for case in, if you take a case of India, then it will be selling tour packages within India for Indians. While ground operators are commonly known as handling agencies of the main companies who cannot open and implement their tours at various destinations. So those companies hires a local level company to take care of their client. They are called ground operators. When we talk about the linkages of tour operator company, then as you know that whole tourism industry is so when we see the linkages of tour operator or tourism business, we can see that tourism industry is not a single type of industry. It is associated with many other industries, whether it is a accommodation industry. In transportation, we have a different level of transportation, whether it is a water transportation, cruise businesses, or air transportation, or surface or rail transportation. In addition to transportation, banking are also very key important in the tourism industry, because nowadays more and more transactions are happening through banking system, app system, technology, use of different technology, and ultimately the bankings are involved in these, in between the customer and these technologies. For international travel, you know that very well that overseas medical policies are required, so insurance companies are also stakeholder of that. Travel trade associations, that is whether it is a TAI, IATO, FHRI, FICCI, CII, or whosoever is supporting tourism industries, are giving their ideas, evaluating your projects, and trying to give you a direction that whether particular project or particular tour packages can be successful, or what are the negative and positive impact of that. On the above, you can see that government agencies or educational institutes are key functions. So on the top, government agencies and educational institutions are always there to guide business operation companies related to tourism. Now we'll see that how, what are the process or guideline for getting a Ministry of Tourism, Government of India recognition as an approved tour operator company. There are a few important guidelines which you are able to see in details. I'll also attach the file by the ministry. But the most important thing is to get a approval or recognition by Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, is that the company should have a minimum 1 year working experience before apply to Ministry of Tourism recognition. And application nowadays is an online process. Earlier it used to be a proper format, but now you have to only apply through e-portals, which will be, details will be given later on. And the basic requirement is at least the company should be located and set up in India, having minimum paid up capital of 3 lakh rupees. And there is always a relaxation in a northeast region for any such kind of restriction. Like for normal reason, you need a 3 lakh rupees paid up capital, while 50,000 rupees is required for northeast region. So turnover in term of foreign exchange earning by such kind of form in a particular financial year or calendar year should be minimum of 25 lakhs. But for northeast region, it is 5 lakhs. There are some important guidelines also, like the office should have in charge of a owner, a full-time member, who must have a adequately trained experience in the matter regarding transportation, accommodation, airlines, and general travel-related services. Nowadays, it is mandatory to have a minimum of 4 qualified staff, out of which at least one should have a diploma degree in tourism and travel management recognized by universities or IITM or AICT. For those companies who are working in northeast region or remote areas or rural areas, that minimum staff should be 2 in spite of 4, and out of which one employee should have a degree diploma in tourism. That is important for students of tourism. The other guideline is should have a minimum office space of 150 square feet, and for rest of the India it is 100 square feet, and if it is a hilly area, then it must be 100 meter above the sea level. You should have your income tax returns papers, and the company should hire regional level tourist guide trained and licensed by Ministry of Tourism, Government of India. If you all qualify and you have documents related to approval and recognition, then you have to apply through online system, through Ministry of Tourism, Government of India website, that is tourism.gov.in, which is mentioned here also, by paying rupees 3000 as a non-refundable charges. And there is a committee which on the basis of north, south, east, west, through its regional tourism director offices, having different members of IATO or TAI or Hotel Association, state tourism, and they go and visit and see, do inspection of your tour operation company, and if they'll find suitable, then they'll send recommendation to Ministry of Tourism, and on the basis of recommendation of the committee, the Ministry of Tourism will grant and recognize the company as a Government of India approved company, and they'll highlight the name and addresses, contact at the incredibleindia.org site as well as Tourism Ministry website. So you'll be promoted all over the world that who are the companies approved by Government of India Ministry of Tourism. Right now, what Tourism Ministry is showing on their web page, that how many different types of tour operator companies who are registered by Government of India. So as we can see, inbound tour operators 523, adventure tour operator 51, domestic tour operator 153, travel agents 207, and tourist transport operator 122. So you can see that inbound tour operators are highest in number. So they are operating very well. And these are the three steps by which you can do process of the recognition of a company to a Ministry of Tourism approved company. Okay, now let us discuss that what are the processes through which a tour packages can be developed and can be operated. So it looks very simple that a company is offering a European discovery of 7 days, 8, 6 night, and then Bangkok, Thailand, and the Singapore, Malaysia, 5 nights, 4 days, it's like that. But to make or to create that particular package involves so much. That's why when we discuss about the travel agency and tour operator, this is the place where it makes a difference, that how tour operators are quite big in compared to the travel agency, because they have a proper research and development team which does research that which package that company should create so that package is well accepted in a market as well as it gives the profit to the company. So a basic level, a basic research is done by that particular company on the basis of the concept of STP, segmenting, targeting and positioning. When a company see that which segment they want to cover, like this, if they want to do on European market, they can go to Europe or Southeast or US market or Australia market. Then it is the target, who are their target, whether let us say that middle income group or youngster or family people, or what is the positioning. The positioning is on the basis of quality versus price matrix. So company can plot that the existing product which is available in a market, and what are their quality or inclusive or inclusion in that versus the prices. And maybe company can decide that they can give good quality with a less price will be good to create such kind of packages. So these are the marketing tools by which they can identify that where and which product they can start. When they can fix that segmentation, targeting and positioning, then they can look for typically which product is good for that. So identifying that, suppose let us say that they are focusing on Europe, or maybe if inbound tour operator, if they are focusing on Buddhist circuit, then what are the product? If the product is finalized, what could be the prices and how to do promotion? And finally, what are the channels through which they'll sell their product? And finally, when the product is ready, it will go to the market and sold to the client. Client will start booking. It will be implemented And feedback can be given to the company again, that what are the do's, don'ts, positive, negative things are done. And finally, the company has the full control over that. So this is the basic of process of marketing for creation of a product. Let us discuss in detail that how we can design it and create a tour package. Of course, it looks like a very simple stage process, but it is a little complex. That's why we have a bigger companies who actually create a major successful tour packages like Cox & Kings or Thomas Cook or Kohani. These are the big companies having a separate segment, separate department to create new products. They say product procurement. So maybe initially the first step will be when the government has decided to promote a particular area or city or hill station or mountain or whatever, then they decide that let us give and involve let us give opportunity to the private players, because tourism is basically managed and run by the private players. So they involve private players, organize pre-tour planning and see that what are the feasibility of creating a packages to a particular area. Then there will be initial research about the destination and what whether the market is existing or not, and whether they'll be getting some potential client or not. Then on the basis of that, they'll develop the itinerary. And during development of itinerary, initially several itineraries can be developed. And finally, after the discussion and several visit to that particular site and doing some fam tours, then final itinerary can be designed. To give different kind of services at the local destination, we must need some local destination companies or who will be supporting you for organizing and implementing those tour packages. Next step will be the costing and pricing of that tour package. So once you have decided which product, at what location, what are the services are required, then the next step will be the costing of the tour packages. And that is very crucial for a company, especially when you are thinking about that selling particular number of a tour package initially will at least reach to the break-even point, and later on you can generate a profit out of that. So a tour package is not such kind of thing, especially when you look at the travel agency, that you a walking client goes to the travel agency, you say that I want to go particular this site, and you want to please add the travel services or accommodation services or sightseeing services, and that particular package is very much tailor-made and customized to a particular client, and the job is over. But this development of tour packages is a completely different process, and it involves a huge investment and time and very skillful exercise. So tour costing is one among that, one of the process which involve very expertise eyes on that how best the tour can be designed and how best and reasonable tour costing can be done. For tour costing and fixing the prices, negotiation with the vendors are very much required, that what are the best prices you can get to finalize for your tour package, because the best negotiation will give you best profit range. Finally, when the pricing is done, negotiation is done, contracting all local service providers is done, then your package is ready, your product is ready, and then we design a tour package of particular brochure of a particular tour package. And once the tour brochure is ready, whether it is in print form or digital form, and it is distributed to all channel for promotion of product, then internally in the operation department of a particular tour company will develop its reservation system, that after receiving a call or inquiry call, how to proceed. So there is a system for operation department, that how the call of inquiry call will be received, follow-up, then converting inquiries into business, and then implementation of a business, all will be done. And then marketing of a tour package to all channels, whether national, international, whatever types of marketing. So, and finally, actual tour operation takes place. And before actual tour operation takes place, we also organize a FAM tour to see whether if there is any lack in a tour, so that at final level it can be corrected. So these are the basic of how to design a tour and different stages of tour. As we have said that tour package creation is a long process. Money, huge money is involved, as well as time is required. As you can see that in research and planning part, mostly takes 1 year, first year, then negotiation and final contracting second year, administrative process second year, marketing third year, and finally operation third year. So to create a very big, massive and very important tour package, at least 1 to 3 years time can be taken by the tour operator company to finally decide that whether this tour, a new product, is ready for a particular company or not. So now come to the what is itinerary, like how to make an itinerary for a tourist, and what are the different types of itinerary, and how a sample itinerary can be created. So itinerary simply can be understood as a tour program or tour timetable for different purposes. So it includes the destinations we are going to visit, or it includes the different services which is included there, which kind of hotel you are staying in that, or what are the meal plan included in that, whether it includes a sightseeing or not. So such kind of things are included in itinerary, but in a very short form, so that it is easy to compile the itinerary and easy to understand, and it will also help in developing the costing of particular itinerary. So basic of itinerary is like you must give an adequate time to your customer that whatever tour package, whatever tour plan you are making, he is able to enjoy and understand that particular tour plan. Then we have to choose appropriate class of hotel or meal plan and transport. So depend on the target population, that which kind of tourist you want to target, you'll be choosing what kind of hotel, meal plan, or what types of transportation will be offered in that itinerary. Then third is avoid backtracking and don't overstretch. So as you know that when we make itinerary, we'll try to make as smooth as possible, rather than just zigzag coming to one place, then going to another same direction, then movement like that. These kind of things should be not done. Then if you first you have to create a main itinerary, and then if you can offer a optional excursions. So whether if you are going to Jaipur, then can you go to Ajmer also or not, it depend on the client. So if you are making Jaipur, focus main, create a main itinerary based on Jaipur, and give may you can give offer that optional excursion also. Excursion generally going on the same day and returning on the same day. And then once your itinerary is fixed and booking is done, or you know, you are receiving the call, inquiry call, you have to block your accommodation in advance, as well as if the customer or your timetable in a such a way that it may require early check-in or late check-out, so you have to inform your hotel for that particular requirement. Of course, if you are going to visit some restricted area like in Northeast, or if you go to Sikkim, there are several places where you need an inner line permit. So you need to take permission from concerned authority in case you are visiting to a restricted area. Clearly specifies what are the includes and what are the excludes. That is a very important, most important thing in an itinerary that will avoid you in the future, that whether you are going to face so much of discussion, hot discussion or bad feedback from the customer or not. So you have to very specifically define that what are the things which is included in your particular itinerary. For example, if you are making an international tour package, and if you have not very specifically said that whether visa charges is included or excluded, then every time there is some fight between customer and tour operator that I haven't said that visa prices are included or excluded. So it is better to specify, give a proper space in a tour brochure telling about details of what are the includes and what are the excludes of the your services. That will solve your many of the problems later on. Now, when we are doing costing, we have to avoid certain things and be sure that these things are ready before doing the costing. So as we have already said that a good itinerary will help for making a good tour costing. So it is, first of all, most important thing is to create a good itinerary and detailed itinerary so that you cannot miss any services. When you are making costing, if you are missing the services, you will miss the cost of a particular service. So it is important to create well detailed itinerary first. And when I'll be dealing with discussing with the types of itinerary, then we'll be telling you what are the important things in that. So when you are making costing, be sure that you have to know that hotel rates generally revise in September. So if you are making your booking your hotel after September, you have to check that whether the hotel has revised rates or not. When we are doing the transfer from airport or railway station or doing some sightseeing, which includes portrays or guide fee or any other foreign languages are required, guides are required. So these all things need or take extra charges. So you have to know that these things are included, and that's why you will be mentioned in your costing. Ensure alternate reservation if it is waitlisted. So generally it happens in train reservation, but very rarely in air reservation. So you have to take care that if the your reservation is not confirmed or your hotel is not confirmed, what are the alternate of that. Check if there is any festival or cultural event to be taken place during your tour program, whether it is a highlight of your tour or whether it will be a problem. Like for example, during the Rath Yatra time in Puri, the whole roads will be blocked. Of course, that is an attraction. So you can't, a person who is not able to walk for a longer distance of time, they'll be not able to visit the temple. So flight or train timing should be checked 45 days before or maybe very one day before, because these days these timetables are so much flexible and we have facility to check. So as soon as possible, as near date, you can check and inform your customer. These are the types of journey which generally created in any tour plans, specifically if it involves airline journey. So it's a one-way journey when going at leaving one city and reaching to the other city, it's called one way. Like origin in first case, it is going to Frankfurt and then reaching to the Singapore. Circular trip is starting origin destination, then taking a circle around that particular area or region and returning back to the same destination. Round trip journey just between origin and destination should be same, and which may include another destination. So Delhi, Zurich, Delhi. Round the world. Round the world is a very special kind of tour generally, which involve more than two continent in the same journey. Because here it started from Tokyo to Vancouver to Oslo, and then returning back to Oslo. Open jaw journeys are generally like if you're traveling to from one destination, CCU is Kolkata, to Madrid to Bangalore, but Madrid to Bangalore dates are not clear. So you know that Kolkata to Madras, Madrid or Madras, which is Chennai, if you are going to on a particular date in May or June, but you don't know the dates of Chennai to Bangalore. So this particular segment is open. The dates are not expired. That's why they are called open job. This is what we are, I was telling in our earlier slide, that what are the types of itinerary. So one itinerary which you see generally at the all website or brochure is tourist itinerary. And the major highlight, major highlight of a tourist itinerary is giving more emphasis on the destination and the services. Like what are the destination will be covered during the particular package and what are the services included. While the tour manager itinerary is very important for that particular company because it includes each and every details, because tour manager should know each and everything of particular package. And on the basis of tour manager's itinerary, basically costings are created. Vendor itinerary, like it is given to a particular vendor, then what are the services required for by him, that will be only highlighted. Transport or bus driver itinerary, the bus driver should know that at what time, it, which hotel the client should be taken and where it will be, he will be or they will be dropped. So basically highlighting the whole travel plan, especially mention about the timings. While tour escort also create a special itinerary based on his services. So these are the types of main itinerary, but mostly most important is this tourist itinerary and tour manager's itinerary. What are the resources to be discussed or seen before planning an itinerary? Of course, client. Who are your client? Who are your target client? That is very much important. Different travel guidebooks are available, highlighting about destination services or what are the good things about that. You can consult. National and Regional Tourism Board. Nowadays, in the time of a digital world, you can see the different websites of state and regional government offices where they'll be highlighting their own products. Periodicals, different magazines and journals highlighting the tourism attraction or services or experiences about that particular thing. Travel Tourism Organization, ITO, FICCI, like that. And then some confidential tariff which is given only to vendors. It is not available to the client. That should be always with you when you are quoting those prices, so that you can create a costing with a margin for a profit. Computer and internet are basic requirement for making itineraries. Now, definition of a tour package. So basically, now you must be knowing what is tour package. So tour package is a tour in which totality of services will be included. Like, so all the services which required for completion of a tour is included in that, whether it is a origin place or tourism attraction to accommodation. So you know the concept of 5A: attraction, accommodation, accessibility, ancillary services and amenities. So included in that and a specific package cost should be there. So costing should be important thing about any tour package. So plan and cost. Now this is the one of the example of a company how they create a itinerary. So name of a company, name of a tour, who is the team leader, how many passenger, their contact number, day, date, sector, what are the activity they are doing, and any remark. So this is the format of a basic itinerary making. Now let us see a sample domestic itinerary as well as international itinerary. This particular itinerary is a golden triangle for visiting Delhi, Jaipur and Agra. So this is telling about how your itinerary is moving day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, and this is mentioning particular date. If a particular date has been already decided, then how dates will move, what are the sectors you are traveling, and tour program. Like at what time you have arrived at the airport and transferred to the hotel, there will be a breakfast or not, or if a city tour, by which transportation and what are the attraction you are covering, where you will take lunch, and what type of meal plan is included in hotel. So these includes in itinerary. These are part of itinerary. So this example of Delhi, Jaipur, Agra. So first, the second day covering Delhi and then leaving for Jaipur, then day covering destination and attractions of Jaipur. Then from Jaipur, you are leaving to Agra. Then 6 day you are covering different attraction of Agra. Most important is Taj Mahal, no doubt. And while returning from Delhi, Agra to Delhi via Secunderabad, and finally transfer to the your airport or railway station to your home. So this is the sample of one itinerary, a basic itinerary. This is a sample of international itinerary which will be covering from departure from India, reaching to France, Paris city, and what are the destination Paris city covered by you, then Brussels and London, and finally from London to India. So example of international itinerary. So these are the types of tour package, whether it is an independent tour, escorted tour, or hosted tour, or incentive tour. These are the types of tour. Independent tour, generally it is a plan for independent tour client, where escort or guides are not important, not included. Where second one, escorted tour are important. Third one, then there is a host company which will be taking care. And incentive travel tours are generally the incentive given by particular company, and tour is designed as per the sponsored company. What are the significance of the tour pack? Why we should take a tour pack? Why not you should take independent services? It is very much time saver. Suppose you have to plan your own journey, it kills your time like anything to see, evaluate, and then whether the information is correct or not. So it takes a lot of time. So tour operator company helps you to save a lot of time. It increases the seasonality of a destination. So a company may promote certain destination in a particular time, so it may increases that. So less cost or price. Since this tour operator company do a very big exercise of creating a tour package, which involve negotiation and purchasing the services in a whole or bulk, so their prices are lesser than an individual walk-in plan. Earning foreign exchange, if the foreign, suppose it is the case of IBT, then international tourists coming and visiting India, they'll be paying much of the part in foreign currency, so the particular country will also earn a foreign currency. Their services are done by the professional services, so they are well managed. Variety of tour packages are created by a company, so you can choose. And if you are a corporate company, then they can give you the services in a bulk with a discount also. So these are the advantages of selling tour packages, because in a less time you can sell more, increase security, ease, convenience, cost saving, less time in planning, easier and safer, and social also, because in tour package many people are involved. This is the sample of a tour costing sheet, and depend on the single occupancy, double occupancy, and triple occupancy, the costs are prepared. As you know that mostly the costs are depend on the number of passenger, as well as for a particular service like hotel, many client prefer single occupancy, but maybe some can share the room, then the cost will be less than if you are sharing triple occupancy, or mostly in a family, then cost will be less. So whether inbound or outbound transportation, porter, accommodation, city transportation, guide fee, miscellaneous, several other things every day, day one, day two, day three, are included on the basis of single, double, and triple occupancy. And finally, this is an example of one tour package created by the particular company. So date, which sector, what are the charges? All charges are in US dollars. The charges of transfer or sightseeing or accommodation, and finally, total price can be calculated. So this is all over about that. What is a tour operator company? What are the types of tour operator company? How to get recognition of a tour operator company? How a tour packages can be created? How research can be done? What are the different types of itinerary? How to create itinerary? And finally, how to create a costing? So this makes a complete understanding about tour package management. Thank you very much.